This is the SEPTA escalator at Broad Street that maimed a seven-year-old boy. It is the escalator that now has cost SEPTA $51 million in the boy's lawsuit. It's Tuesday night. Lisa's off. Monica Malpass joins us. And the big story on Action News tonight is a jury's huge judgment against SEPTA. The mother of seven-year-old Sharif Hall filed the suit accusing SEPTA of negligence in the accident that cost the boy his foot. It was back in 1996 that Sharif got caught in the top of the escalator. His foot was ripped off. His family's lawyer showed the jury evidence that SEPTA knew the escalator was dangerous but failed to fix it. Clearly, the jury agreed by coming down with a $51 million plus judgment. Of that money, $50 million will go to the boy and more than $1 million will go to his mother. That specifically includes an extra $65 to pay for the boy's shoes. Vernon Odom will have much more on this story in a live report coming up on Action News at 6.
Big story on Action News tonight. A dramatic victory for a seven-year-old boy in his mother's legal fight against SEPTA. The boy lost his right foot in an escalator accident at a SEPTA subway station, and today a jury said that was worth over $50 million. The boy's name is Sharif Hall. He now walks with a prosthetic foot. His family says the accident will eventually cost them $300,000 in medical bills, but a jury found the Transit Authority liable for much more than that. Action News reporter Vernon Odom is live at City Hall with the full story. Vernon?
Jim, the jury deliberated today for more than 4.5 hours before returning the verdict against SEPTA. The jury obviously telling the Mass Transit Authority that the young boy and his family never should have had to endure this. Deneen Hall left court tonight without comment. Her lawyer says she's too emotional in the wake of the jury award of over $51 million. Her son, seven-year-old Sharif, lost his right foot 3 years ago when it got snagged in a faulty SEPTA escalator at this North Broad Street subway station. The jury found that SEPTA was negligent because it knew this escalator was unsafe and in need of repair. Therefore, it was ruled a violation of Sharif's civil rights.
The jury said that there was a state-created danger, a constitutional violation of Sharif Hall's civil rights.
SEPTA had tried to blame the accident on Sharif's mother, but SEPTA never presented a defense at all here at the trial after this folder of SEPTA documents was revealed in court, proving SEPTA knew, as far back as 1994, that the escalators were dangerous.
This is a wake-up call to SEPTA. The escalators are in a disgraceful condition to this day. Any person who rides SEPTA knows that. And this jury was just speaking out. They must be corrected.
The jury awarded Sharif Hall $25 million for his physical and emotional suffering, and $25 million more for the civil rights violation, plus $1 million to Deneen Hall for her suffering and trauma, plus a symbolic $65 their lawyers asked for to replace the boy's mangled shoes. The civil rights claim against SEPTA allowed the jury to exceed the $250,000 limit on liability of public agencies. The Transit Authority says it will appeal the mammoth award.
To claim in legal terms that the civil rights of young Sharif were violated by deliberate indifference of SEPTA is beyond reason.
Judge Frederica Messiah Jackson has launched hearings to decide if SEPTA should be held in contempt for holding back the documents that showed that SEPTA's top management knew about the serious escalator safety problems.
It's a tragic mistake.
Well, it's only a mistake. It was an oversight.
It was an oversight. It was a tragic mistake.
Not a cover-up.
Not a cover-up.
Jim, Hall's lawyer claims that SEPTA was trying to deliberately keep those documents from seeing the light of day. If Judge Messiah Jackson finds SEPTA in contempt, she could fine them another $1 million. Live at City Hall, Vernon Odom, Channel 6 Action News. Jim?
Thank you.